I said, I want to do this as a bit, but I'm going to have to say that you said that you didn't like Mexicans. Is that going to bother you? And she was like, yeah, maybe, because I go to school with a lot of Mexicans, Dad. And she's like, maybe next year when I go to private school, but not right now. And so I said, and then in the car, I said to her, I go, you, it doesn't have anything to do with race. I go, you know, the type of people that come to your house and they don't pay for anything and they eat all the good snacks right away and then they eat all the good drinks and when you go out to eat, they never offer to pay. And Georgie goes, oh, you mean mom's family? I went, yeah, they're poor people. You
that
don't like poor people.
That is so funny, dude.
But it's all around this world. No one likes poor people, you know?
Yeah.
And like they have it in England. But it's they just happen to be white. So they don't have racism. But in our country, our media has taken it to make it look like the black people are the poor people. The Mexicans are the
classism,
poor people.
Classism.
Yeah.
Is that a word?
Yeah.
Is that a
I
word?
Mean, it's very interesting that, you know, they act like we're the only ones who care about race. I know in comedy they don't like to hear racial jokes that much. But I think that
exhausting.
Our society in America, we have been brainwashed and basically beat down into everything is racial.
Yeah.
And that's so we don't get along and we don't pay attention to what's going on. And that's my honest opinion, man.
But I think it's beautiful, to, you know, for them, the psychopaths that run the world. I think it's brilliant. Just start mixing a bunch of fucking different races. And then as long as they're fighting, yeah, it doesn't matter if it's about race, if it's about politics, or if it's about religion. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
The
main goal is
really.
To get them to fight. It doesn't matter why they're fighting.
Do you
Trump,
believe,
Hillary,
do you believe there's like
fight.
An Illuminati that's running things, that's kind of pulling the strings?
Can I say something, dude?
Yeah.
There are eight families that own pretty much the Federal Reserve. They own almost all of both every state's centralized bank.
Really?
Okay. And these eight families own the biggest chunks of every Fortune 500 company. So they literally own everything. And that makes me feel that television is just a shell game because these people own the channels and they own the people advertising on the channels. So it's just a move of money type thing, dude. I mean, when you take a look at it, it is insane. And everybody wants to blame Rothschilds. I think they're the boogeyman. They're one of them, but they're used as the bad guys. There's people even above them. This Black Nobility people, they're out of Italy. Have you heard of them? They're the Black Nobility. They're the
Black Nobility.
They're called Black Nobility, man, and nobody knows them because that's how you know they got real power because nobody talks about them. They are old banking families from Rome. They've been around since Rome, dude.
Wow.
And they are like the real G's, dude. And the Rothschilds are one of them. You know, then the royal family. It's so funny watching these everybody celebrate the royal family. You're like, Queen Elizabeth was literally just found guilty of the disappearance and pretty much the death of like 10 orphan children in a world court. She was convicted.
Wait, for real?
She'll never be, ever.
You'll never know about it because the media covers up. But there's so much shit going on in politics right now. I've never been so deep
into politics.
Dude,
the royal family
right
backed the Nazis.
You'll just never hear about it. There's so much going on. There's so many people in politics, so many people getting fired, switching jobs. All these like in politics.
I mean, deputy of House Intelligence Committee, special counsel, Senate minority leader. There's so many politicians and all these lawyers and prosecutors in the Department of Justice. There's so many people. It's not just Trump and Pence and then, and before him it was Obama. There's a shitload of people. It's like Game of Thrones. Trying to really follow politics, what's really going on. Yeah. There's a whole shitload of people. And have you heard of QAnon?
No.
See, anonymous? Man, that's a long story.
Oh,